Hello everybody, Spornite here. Welcome to another vlog. Wanted to give another little update to you guys. So, first thing I wanted to talk about is this past week for me was spring break, and that was really fun. My family went down to Florida, which for those of you outside of the U.S., that's like at the very south of our country, the U.S., and we visited Cape Canaveral, which is one of the NASA bases, Universal Orlando, and Disney World, Walt Disney World. So that was a lot of fun, and that was really great to do. That was basically my spring break. If you want to know anything more about it, just ask me down below in the comments, and I'll reply to it. Next thing I wanted to talk about is, as of this video, I'm actually out of content for the channel, so I'm hoping to record in the near future, and then I'll have some content in order to upload. So I'll be working on that, so we should have something for next week's video without falling behind. So that's my goal, and I want for you guys to know that I'm going to do my best for that. Third thing, I was transferring my save. I had to re-image my computer, basically reinstall Windows and everything, and Undertale was saved onto the computer. So I transferred the files over to my external hard drive, and I thought it saved everything. Well, apparently it didn't save my save file. So I'm actually starting over, and this time I'll be working on the pacifist route. I'll catch up to the point that I was at when the last video went up, but I'll do everything pacifist. Like, I'll the training dummy I won't kill, Toriel I won't kill, this time I'll spare them, so that way it can get the pacifist ending. And basically I'm going to do two run-throughs, once with pacifist and once with genocide, and then after that it'll be, if you guys want some more then I'll post some more, but I think that's a pretty good wrapping up point, and then I'll just play Undertale by myself after that. The final thing before we get onto the main topic of this video that you guys voted for on Twitter, which was anime, I wanted to say that I'm going to also try to run two series instead of just Undertale, just so you guys get a little bit of variance of content. So depending on how much I get to record, I might upload two videos a day, but that's not a promise right now. It will for sure be one video per week with the possibility of two videos. So maybe like 1 week has a single video, the next week has two videos or something like that. I'll work something out, but you guys for sure will have one video per week, and that's a promise to you. Okay, so the main topic is anime, and I was having problems coming up with some questions, so I went and asked a fellow YouTuber, somebody I now consider a friend, some help for developing some questions. And her YouTube channel name is FTW for the Win, Girl Gaming, and her content's really cool. I really enjoy watching it, and we're going to get to do a Let's Play together in the future. It's going to be on the PS4, so that's going to be some of my first actual console content on this channel, and I think it'll be a neat experience for both of us. So anyways, on to the questions. The first question she asked is, what is your favorite anime and why? For me, I have to say definitely Kill la Kill. It was just so amazing to see all the fight scenes. The characters are great. It has an excellent story. Just everything all around is really good about the show. It's really funny as well. There's a lot of really funny scenes. Now, for sub versus dub, either are great. But for me personally, the jokes were a little bit more localized with the dub, so it was actually funnier, I feel, with the dub there. But it's great to watch both ways. So, okay, the next question was your preferred genre. My favorite genre is, believe it or not, rom-com, shortly followed by romance. Now, that may seem a little bit odd, but for some reason, there's just something about romance that really draws me in and just seems really interesting. And rom-coms can be hilariously funny just because, like, there's a lot of awkward situations that are brought up that, like, people in everyday life would be experiencing as well, or maybe just a little bit drawn out, but it gets really funny. So I highly suggest any sort of rom-com series to watch. Third question was, when did you start watching anime? I started watching anime back in January 2015. I had watched a couple of, like, minor shows, Lucky Star and the likes of those, many years prior to that. Oh god, that was my freshman year, so 2013 or even earlier, actually. Like, I'm excluding Pokemon. Everybody's seen Pokemon. Okay, not everyone's seen Pokemon, but a large majority of people have seen Pokemon. So, Lucky Star was my first introduction, basically, into anime, and that I saw back in 2013 or 2012. End of 2012, early 2013. And that's really funny, especially the little ending outro piece called Lucky Channel. That was my favorite part. So funny. How often do you watch? For me, I watch it fairly often, but I actually haven't watched any anime for about 3-4 months now, just because I've been focusing on schoolwork. Schoolwork comes first, so that's important to me, and I actually have a lot of catching up to do on anime, but I'll get it all done eventually. And then list five you'd recommend. I'm actually going to suggest six, in addition to the ones I've already listed, Kill la Kill and Lucky Star. Those are both great, but the six I'm going to list are Toradora, which is a rom-com, Tenari no Kaibutsu-kun, which in English is My Little Monster. The anime is excellent. The manga is even better, so I suggest both of those. That's a romance. Anohana, it's a really beautiful story, really happy, really sad, some funny parts. It's excellent to see. Everyone should experience it. I will promise, though, that when you watch it, either you'll cry or you're heartless. it's that type of show, especially towards the end. And then there's kind of a more common one, but one that I really liked a lot, created by the same studio that made Kill la Kill, which is Triggered. It's Tengen Toppa Gurren Lagann, or most people just say Gurren Lagann. That was an excellent show. To me, it ended a bit too early, but I think it'd be great to see to go and see that, especially before watching Kill la Kill, because there's some little Easter eggs in Kill la Kill about Gurren Lagann. So both are great to see. I suggest them both. And then Charlotte, that was just this past fall that came out. Basically, they are high school students and they have superpowers, and that's pretty good. There was some interesting, it was a very interesting storyline that was built up, and some plot twists I wasn't expecting. I could go on and on with the lists, but the other one that I was thinking of was One Punch Man. One Punch Man is basically a parody on anime, so it's just like all these really, like, overdone scenes about anime that are have another layer of it being overdone, so it's just really funny, all the stuff that goes on. So I'll suggest any of those for pretty much anyone to watch. If you want any more suggestions about anime, I could either make a dedicated video talking just about anime, solely about anime, or I could talk to you guys about it down in the comment section below. Actually, just leave me a comment about that, and I'll be happy to reply. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like down below, and leave a comment. I'd be happy to talk with some of you guys. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.